Yeah, here we have a speaker, Mr. Bhautik Sheth from India, who is the founder of IVPANAN Digital Marketing Services, co-founder of Charismatic Academy, the personal coaching center for management of subjects, having 11 plus years of corporate marketing, academics and digital marketing experience, served as an online trainer for Google and Manipal Global Education, Bangalore Google Digital Marketing Program. So now I request you, sir, to go up with your session.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much for the great introduction. Hi, this is Bhautik Sheth from Surat, India. I'm the founder of IVPANAN Digital Marketing Services, and we are into the business of digital marketing consultancy and training as well. So first of all, thank you so much, team of Global Digital Marketing Summit, for inviting me as a keynote speaker. And as I was listening to so many speakers throughout the day, and what I learned that the great challenge for all the speakers, what they have found till the date, is how to get the maximum traffic on the website. So now I'm also going to speak on the same theme. I'm going to talk about how social media can be used for the search engine optimization. Now, when we see that many of us know that what is exactly the meaning of digital marketing. But even if you try to understand digital marketing from all the different perspectives, we basically want to engage people online, and this engagement comes from different ways. So it's not always about that somebody is going to visit your website from search engine optimization. Nowadays, like when the social media is doing everything, you have to take social media as one of the most important tool to get the traffic on your website. Because website is playing the key role in achieving the objective of the business, you cannot forget that you should have the website, because the ultimate conversions are happening on the website. And this is what we have observed from many of our clients and many of the clients globally, that they are least concerned about the importance of the website, although they want to sell the products, although they want to do the conversions. But when it comes to the importance of the website, they are not so serious about it. Although they are very serious about the social media marketing. But here we need to understand one thing, that nothing works in the isolation. Even if you are using the social media, you have to have your website. And if at all you are having your website, you are trying to get your website on the top of the search engine, you must have to go with your social media marketing as well. So how we can take advantage of the website? Now, basically everybody is saying, even like my co-speakers, they all have said the content is the king. Yes, absolutely, content is the king, because it is the most important element of digital marketing if you really want to complete your conversion. Now, you need to understand one thing very clearly, that internet is just a tool, internet is just a medium. There are two different human beings are connected through internet. That connection can be happening through website, that connection can be happening through your social media, but at the same time, if you are not communicating as a human through your content, maybe the people to whom you want to communicate will not get satisfaction. And that is the reason that nowadays the content has become more sensible if navigation of the website is meaningful. So here comes the role of the navigation of the website as well. Just imagine you are going to some retail outlet, you want to buy something. You are looking for some products in the retail outlet, but you are not able to find it. Even you are not able to find the proper signage over there. Definitely you are going to get frustrated. Now this frustration is not because that the product is not available in the shop. Rather, this frustration is because you have not been guided properly to that particular rack where the product has been displayed. The same thing happened when you are taking the traffic through search engine optimization on your website. You are taking people from your social media to your website. But if you are not navigating them properly, and if you are not able to helping them to achieve their objective, maybe they will leave your website. So you cannot afford, when you are doing all the hard work, you cannot afford anybody to leave your website. And believe me, you must need to optimize your website, because you need to take some advantage of the search engine. And since morning, we are listening to so many speakers that many of them have spoken about the algorithm, the changing way of algorithm, how algorithm were working before and now. And we need to accept one thing, guys, that algorithm is going to keep changing. You cannot say that everything is going to be static. Yes, it is going to be changing, and maybe later or sooner you will see these changes. It will take faster. So what to do? Do we need to keep our SEO strategy changing every time when the algorithm is getting changing? Or maybe we need to take help of the other tools as well? That is the question we all need to ask to ourselves, because we are doing all the hard work when we really want to take the advantage of the search engine optimization. So this is what we need to understand over here. Now, when we are talking about the social media as well, and you know what, that everybody is thinking that social media is the most easiest channel which can create the connection and or maybe the relationship with the people. It can help people in generating the network, and those people can be your customers, those people can be your prospective buyers, these people can be your prospective buyers. But at the end of the day, you are looking to get near to those people, you are looking to get connected with all those people. So yes, social media has become a cornerstone of consumer life, and we cannot ignore this fact. But yes, it is not only used for connection, but it also plays a key role in search engine optimization as well. Although when we talk about search engine optimization, normally we speak about what? We speak about the keywords, we speak about the HTML tags, maybe if we are talking about some advanced SEO, we may speak about the schema and AMP, and there are so many other things. We have to speak about, you know, the loading speed of the website, web pages. You are talking about some tools like Search Console, you are talking about Google Analytics, because everything comes together. But why to forget social media in that? We cannot afford to miss social media, because when you see to the page rank, the way page rank is working, you have to consider the traffic as well. And if you are not considering traffic, maybe you are missing something. So guys, here I'm going to put two things forward. Obviously, one is social media and another would be blogs. Blogs are my personal favorite, and I believe that blogs can definitely help you a lot in getting your search engine result better. So let us see a few things, guys. We need to understand the collaboration between social media and search engine optimization, because when we are talking about the changing algorithm of Google and Bing, we have to understand that even Facebook and Twitter, they keep changing the algorithm as well. So basically, there is a correlation between social signals and ranking position. It is extremely high. Though I must tell that before 1 or 2 years, it was supposed to in the 2015, Google has said that they don't have to do anything with the social signals. They are not considering social media. But there were some research, there were some data, the data were coming from here and there, and everybody had the different opinion. People were saying that no, even though if Google is saying that they are not supposed to have any influence of social media in the ranking, but yes, there is the influence. There is the influence of the social media on the SERP ranking. So what, how to do that? How you can get that, you know, influence from your social media to help your ranking? Obviously, you need to get people from social media to your website. And then if you are going to create some good content, engaging content, it will most likely be popular on the social media. And also people are probably going to like it and link it to it. And hence what will happen, that when you're sharing any of your content of your website on the social networking site, you will see that many of the people would like to share it. You cannot forget the companies like Scoop, or there are so many other companies even in India, that they regularly share their content of website, their content of the blog from their website to the social media. And then what happens? You will see that all this content what they're sharing from the website to the social media, that so many audiences, the people, they share those on their own personal profile, they share it on their own business page. So it increases the reach through their social media. But at the same time, whenever you feel that you have to connect to that particular web page, you're clicking on the post, you are opening the link, you are going and reading the content on the website. So your good content, your engaging content, even on the website, is bringing people from social media, different social media, to your website only. And you have to remember that great idea of sales funnel. You have to bring people on your landing page on the website, and then gradually, if you can guide them to the conversion page, if you can take them to the ultimate landing page, and you can do the conversion smartly, then you will definitely get a very good, you know, return on investment, because your goal should be very clear. If you are only and only looking to have your website on the top of the search engine and you want to get the psychological satisfaction that yes, my website is coming on the top, but it will not earn you the business, right? You want to earn the business, and that business will only be earned that even if you are coming on the top, even if your website is coming on the top, you should not stop over that. You want people to come and visit your website. You want people to buy something from your website. And if you are not an e-commerce company, then you want people to give you the leads. They need to enter the details so that you can collect the leads. You have to take them to the thank you page. So this has to be your sales funnel. And yes, social media will definitely help you in getting the results. So what I want to convey over here, guys, that search engine optimization is not limited to bringing your website on the first position of your SERP of either Google or Bing. Now, we have to think search engine optimization from the different perspective. I don't mind if my website is not coming on the first position, but if I'm coming on the fifth or sixth position, but my conversion ratio is very high, then I think I should never feel sad that my website is not coming on the top position. We need to look five different ways of social media which can help us in search engine optimization. So one by one, we are going to see these five points. The number one is the potential for the link. That's a good potential, that's a great potential for the link. It doesn't matter whether it's a Twitter, it's a Pinterest, Facebook, maybe Instagram or LinkedIn. If you really make some high good quality content on your social media, then definitely, first of all, people will like to engage with you on the social media. So just imagine, there are nobody on your social networking site. There are hardly few hundreds of the people who have liked your Facebook page. Hardly few people are following you on the Twitter. Hardly there are anybody who is following you on the Pinterest. And believe me, there is nobody, or maybe you are not using Instagram or LinkedIn. Then what will happen? Although you have so good content on the website, but you have nobody to follow from your social networking site and coming to your website. So believe me, it's your biggest loss. So what you need to do to take the advantage of the links between your website and the social media, you have to have a very good crowd. You have to have good people, those people who can purchase from you. You need to have these people on your social networking sites. So yes, normally we have this kind of discussion every now and then that whether there is the role of likes of the Facebook page, is there anything to do with the Instagram followers? That has to do if those people are lesser in the number, but definitely they have the potential to become the client of yours. If this is happening, then maybe you will be able to fetch those people from your social networking site to your ultimately your landing page on your website. So you have to understand the potential for links between social media and your website. The second point is, guys, you have to grow your audience. As I said, if you don't have anybody on your social networking site, then believe me, you are losing the potential to get them, everybody on your website. And yes, because social media, it can be a great and efficient way to help you. It helps in build your brand. It can get in front of people who wouldn't have otherwise found you. So believe me, everybody is not going to search you on the Google. You can have people who are having your needs, who are having the needs of your product and services. But at the same time, you will find those people who maybe they have the need of your product and services, but they have never realized. So if they have never realized about the need of your product or services, they are not going to go and search on the Google, right? So what will happen that if you can reach them on the social media, if you can make them realize about the need of your product, which they have never thought of, then why they would not engage with your content? So first, go create the audience on your social networking site, grow with organic and paid campaigns, then make them realize. You have to make them realize that yes, you are selling the product, you are selling the services, and this product and services can be of your need. It can be a requirement, but you are not capitalizing on your need and requirement. Then, once you are communicating all these things through very great content on social networking site, maybe they would like to know more about you. They would like to know more about your website, your company, your people. And then they are going to come on your website. So guys, you have to create a bridge. If you are failed to create the bridge between your social networking site and your website, you are missing the chance to bring people or from your website, rather from your social media to your website. So the second point is you have to grow your audience. Why we cannot speak about Instagram? Now, I have kept Instagram as a separate topic over here because Instagram is growing. And since Facebook has acquired Instagram, it has evolved like anything. And believe me, it is one of the most used social media app in the world right now. When we talk about Facebook, we talk about Twitter, but you know what? That all the social media we normally use from the desktop and maybe from the mobile as well. With Instagram, you only have one option, that you have mobile in your hand. In a country like India, where there are hundreds and millions of people who are now using internet, there are hundreds and billions of people who have smartphones. So you cannot ignore one fact that the smartphone, you know, the smartphone and internet, it has come out as a deadly combination. Second thing, the millennial generation. These are the people, maybe, who have not initially seen the growth of Orkut or after that the growth of Facebook. But when they all of a sudden they came they explored the possibility of social media. They might have come to know about Snapchat. They might have come to know about Instagram. So these are the people. These are the people of who are going to become your customer tomorrow. These are the people with the age group of 18 or maybe 20 or 25 years. So if they are on Instagram, definitely you have to engage these people even on Instagram. Yes, we know that Instagram, it doesn't have the best linking procedure. And believe me, you can only have one or two places in Instagram where you can, you know, guide people from your Instagram page or post to your ultimate website. But still, you can have a very good strategy. You can bring your people off Instagram from Instagram stories, from stories to your bio, from bio to your landing page on the website. Similarly, if you can do the same thing from your post, you can guide them from your post, from the post to your bio, from the bio again to your landing page. And believe me, this landing page shouldn't be your home page, because home page is the main gate of your house. Rather, you guide them to your room of your house, because you want everybody to come and visit your particular room, because that room has something to offer. And then only you will be able to close the lead. So if you are not able to close the lead, maybe you are not going to get the kind of conversion. You are not maybe able to guide the return on investment, which you are aiming at. So third point is you have to use Instagram very smartly and strategically. The fourth, absolutely YouTube. Now, again, YouTube is one of my favorites. Why YouTube? Because the second most searched engine globally after Google, that all we know. And yes, you can use YouTube to positively influence your SEO performance. Guys, you have to understand one fact that YouTube and Google Plus are, the products of Google itself. And definitely Google is giving lots of weightage to the activity of YouTube on the YouTube and Google Plus. So you should not ignore that. Obviously, I would go one step ahead, not only YouTube, you do not limit yourself with the YouTube and Google Plus. I had this discussion earlier with a few people last week that why to use Google Plus? Because Google Plus, there are not many people who are using Google Plus. There are people who are more used to, go with the Facebook, they are using Instagram, maybe they are using Snapchat, but not Google Plus. Believe me, every time you cannot see to the number of people who are the users of social networking site. You have to consider a few things as well. You have to consider crawler. If maybe crawler is crawling through the Google Plus, if crawler is crawling through the YouTube, if your content is there visible when somebody is searching for the video on Google, why only you are capitalizing on the web page? Why you cannot capitalize on your video on the same keywords, the long tail keyword, which if somebody is searching on the Google search engine, maybe if you have that YouTube video available on your channel, the same YouTube video will come in the search result. You want people to come and watch your video, take very smartly from your YouTube video to your website. So again, you are getting an advantage of traffic. At the same time, at least your brand through your YouTube channel is coming in front of the eyes of the people. So SEO is not limited to getting your website only on the search engine, top search engine result pages, but even your profiles, your YouTube channel, your Google Plus profile, you have to capitalize on these two social networking sites of Google as well. You have to use it. You can create videos. You can create videos to promote your content. You can create videos to promote your brand. And ultimately, all this video, it can lead to the links, and your videos can potentially rank organically in the search engine result pages. So this is the fourth point. You have to use YouTube. You have to use Google Plus. And the fifth and the last point is you have to use the ads. Why to ignore ads? Ads on social media, first of all, is not limited to Facebook. Second, ads, yes, you have to go with the Twitter ads. You can go with the LinkedIn ads. You cannot ignore the reality that there are people on Twitter, there are people on LinkedIn who can click on your ads. So guys, you have to create some great campaigns on Facebook. You can create some good campaigns on Twitter and LinkedIn. You should have some separate budget for the advertisements. You can boost all these campaigns on the different social networking sites with the paid campaigns. Your paid campaign, typically on the Facebook, is not limited to boosting the post. You cannot always think that I need to boost the post. There are almost 11 to 12 different objectives available on Facebook when you are going for the advertisement. You need to understand your objective. So if you want to collect the leads, but if you don't have the landing page on the website, there is no meaning that even you can think that I will take people from my advertisement campaign to my website. Rather, you can create the lead collection form on the Facebook and you collect the leads on the Facebook form only. But if you have a very good landing page on your website where you can collect the data, then you can go with the different campaigns on Facebook. Rather, it can be engagement campaign or the conversion campaign. I will suggest you to go with the conversion campaign. Just create the advertisement, fetch people from your ads to your landing page on the website. Just collect the data from your landing page. And you know what? You have to use the pixel as well. So when you're using the pixel, you will come to know that how the conversions are taking place. So once your conversions are taking place, you will also come to know that from where they have come. So the great combination of Google Analytics and the Facebook pixel all together will give you the result. So this result would be, it will give you the kind of understanding that how your campaigns have performed and what is the role of your website in that. So this you have to do. You have to, go with a separate budget in your ads. If you know how to do SEO, if you have some proficiency in SEO, then maybe you can take out some budget of your marketing and you can spend in the paid advertisements on social media. But if you don't know SEO, you hired some agency of digital marketing, then what you have to do, you just understand your overall budget of marketing. One part of the budget you can spend in search engine optimization, and another part of the budget you can ask to spend in the paid advertisements on social media. So this will give you a very good traffic on the website. But again, I will remind you that whenever you are spending money on social networking site, be very clear with your objective. Your landing page should not be your home page when it comes to the paid advertisements on Facebook or Twitter. Although it will give you the traffic, but that traffic is of no meaning if there is no conversion. So guys, SEO is not only limited to getting your people on your website and getting your result on the top SERP, but you need to understand the fact that you have to focus on the conversion as well. So guys, these are my points. If you have any question, then you can definitely ask me the question.
The participants are really very privileged to be a part of it. So thank you for your session and have a great evening.